My name is Alexis Footman, and I'm the supervisor for HMIS Training and Technical Support. Today, I'm going to be talking about the Contract Performance Report for Housing Navigation. Let's go ahead and get started. So first, I'm going to provide an overview of the CPR, and then we're going to go into a performance goal analysis for housing navigation. And at the end of every section, we're going to have a little review. During this webinar, you will learn how to understand the CPR housing navigation goals and targets, how to record data toward this report, and how to identify the data in HMIS. Housing navigation programs assist persons experiencing homelessness by providing housing-focused case management and supportive services. So what is the contract performance report? It is the contract-specific performance evaluation and compliance report. It's also the report of record for all city and county-funded agencies. The objective is to provide report outcomes for performance targets, to provide a validation tool for successful outcomes, and to inform LASA on how agencies contribute towards moving participants from homelessness to housing. Who is the audience? Homeless service providers funded and contracted by LASA or directly with HUD, and additional funders, including HUD, HCIDLA, DCFS, and the CDC. Here are a few key terms. Performance summary is a report card of the contract's goals, targets, and results. The numerator is the number of participants who met the target, while the denominator is the number of participants who were eligible to meet the target. The outcome is the percentage or ratio of participants who met the target against those who were eligible. The target is a specific plan level of a result to be achieved within a given time frame. The result is an indication of whether or not the target has been met. There are two main sections of the CPR. The summary provides an overall look of the contract performance in reference to the targets. The details provides a participant level analysis of who did and did not meet the contract targets. Here's a look at the CPR summary view. Some of the common questions with this view are, what do these numbers mean? In the summary section, this report provides the totals for participants matching the conditions for the numerator and denominator for the respective targets. How are these numbers achieved? These numbers are pulled and aggregated from specific data points in HMIS. What does met and not met mean in the CPR? Comparing the outcome against the target percentages, your contract met the performance goal if the outcome percentage is greater than or equal to the target percentage. Here's a look at the CPR details view. Some of the common questions here are, which of my participants will appear on this report? This report will capture participants active during the reporting period. Active indicates the participant's enrollment occurred prior to or during the reporting period. So how do I know whether my participant achieved the target? The bolded text on the report correlates to the targets. If the participant achieved the target during the reporting period, then on that line you will see a yes. If they didn't, then you will see a no. Performance goal number one, contracted number to serve. Here's a key term. Number of participants served is the number of persons enrolled in the program at any point during the reporting period. So how is the target for contracted number to serve calculated? For adults and youth, you're looking at the number of participants served by housing navigation divided by the number of participants contracted to be served by housing navigation. The target is 100%, or as many or more participants served than contracted. In this measure, we want to know, did our housing navigation program meet or exceed the number of participants contracted to be served? So where is this information located? The number of participants your program is contracted to serve can be found within your program profile. Let's look at a scenario. A housing navigation program is contracted to serve 100 people. At the end of the contracted year, which is March 31st, 2018, this program has served 108 people. Here is our reporting period. Has the program met the performance target, meaning they achieved the goal within the reporting period? Yes, the program has met the performance target because it served over 100 people during our report period. Now, this would not have been a successful outcome if the program did not serve at least 100 people during our reporting period. Performance goal number 2, housing stability plan within 30 days. Here's a key term. The housing stability plan is a document detailing all the steps both the participant and the provider will take to support the participant in moving towards permanent housing. It identifies the steps needed to build on held resources and barriers to housing, clear benchmarks and timelines for goals, and what the participant or provider is responsible for in the path to housing. Here's an example of a housing stability plan. Let's look at another scenario. Cammie Henderson is presently enrolled in a crisis housing program. She's working full-time and is ready to start looking for a stable housing situation. In July 2017, she enrolls into a housing navigation program. She starts a housing stability plan with her caseworker, and they complete the plan on July 22, 2017. Here's our reporting period, and here's a visual representation of our scenario. As you continue through this section, we will be looking to answer the following questions. Did Cammie achieve the performance goal of completing a housing stability plan within 30 days? Consider the following. Was Cammie enrolled in the program during the reporting period? Was a housing stability plan completed with Cammie within 30 days of her enrollment into the program? And did the enrollment and the completed housing stability plan occur during the reporting period? How is this target calculated? For adults and youth, you're looking at the number of participants with completed housing stability plans within 30 days divided by the total number of participants enrolled in housing navigation. The target is 80%, or 4 out of every 5 participants. In this measure, we want to know how many of our participants completed the housing stability plan during their first 30 days in the program. How is the target captured in HMIS? We track the housing stability plan in HMIS as a service for your program. When the plan is completed, we will record the service in HMIS. The date will reflect the day on which the form was completed with the participant. The form itself can be accessed through the LASA website. Once completed, you can even upload the form into HMIS in the participant's files section. How does this show on the CPR? Here's a visual representation of what this will look like on the report. Now let's revisit our scenario. Did Cammie achieve the performance goal of having a housing stability form completed within her first 30 days in the housing navigation program? Yes. She was enrolled on July 1st. She completed the housing stability plan on July 22nd, and that's within the first 30 days. Would Cammie count towards the program meeting the performance target? Yes. As the goal was achieved within the reporting period, she will be counted towards the target. Performance goal number 3, exit to permanent housing destination or attain referral to HSPP and Rapid Rehousing. Here is a list of applicable permanent destinations at exit. Here's a key term, referral attained. The participant was referred to a service provider who was then able to enroll and or serve the referred participant. For this target, we're specifically looking for a referral attained to housing search and placement or a rapid rehousing program. How is this target calculated? For adults and youth, you're looking at the number of participants exited to a permanent housing destination divided by the number of participants exited from a housing navigation program, or the number of participants who attain a housing search and placement or rapid rehousing referral divided by the number of participants exited from a housing navigation program. The target is 35%, or 7 out of every 20 participants. In this measure, we want to know how many of our participants who have exited from housing navigation, A, exited to a permanent destination, or B, attained a referral to Rapparee Housing or a housing search and placement program. Let's review one final scenario. Larry Lemelson was enrolled in a crisis housing program earlier this year. After finding a job, he connected to our housing navigation program. He was enrolled on July 7, 2017. It was not until August that a housing stability plan was completed with him, but by September, Larry had found an apartment and moved in. On that day, he was exited from the housing navigation program. Here's a visual representation of our scenario. As you continue through this section, we'll be looking to answer the following questions. Did Larry achieve the performance goal and meet the target of exiting to permanent housing during the reporting period? Consider the following. Was he enrolled in the program during the reporting period? Did he exit to a permanent housing destination or attain a referral? Did he exit during the reporting period? How is this target captured in HMIS? At exit, the point at which a participant will no longer receive services under this enrollment, we can mark that a participant is moving into a permanent housing destination. As we are also exiting the participant from the program on the screen, we need to enter the exit destination and the reason for leaving. The exit destination should align to the permanent housing destination they are moving into if their movement marks the end of their need for services from your program. Like the housing stability plan, the referral to either housing search and placement or Rapparee Housing are both recorded as services. We would first mark that the referral was made, referral made, and then once the referred participant was enrolled into the receiving program, we would record the referral as attained, referral attained. How does this show on the CPR? Here's a visual representation of how this would look on the report. And finally, let's revisit our scenario. Did Larry meet the performance goal in this case, meaning the goal was achieved within the reporting period? Yes, Larry did meet the performance goal of exiting to permanent housing or attaining referrals to Rapparee Housing or HSPP, as the goal was achieved within the reporting period. Larry also met the target as he achieved the performance goal within the reporting period. So he would be counted towards the target of exiting to permanent housing destination or attaining referrals to Rapparee Housing or HSPP. For questions, please contact Alan Spring, our data analyst, or Judy Saunders, a data analyst for performance. Thank you for listening and have a great day.